start talking about solving quadratics, would you write this problem down? X squared equals 25. Is that a quadratic?
Yeah.
How do you know if something's a quadratic? X squared, does it have an X squared? Then it's a quadratic. How do you solve that?
You would square it.
You would square it to solve it?
Oh, square root it.
Right? How do you undo a square?
You root it.
Square root it. So would you square root both sides, please? Okay, I'm going to ask you a trick question, and I need you to think about it before you answer. Okay? Okay, the first part's not a trick question. What do we have left on the left-hand side?
X.
Here's the trick question. What do you have on the right-hand side?
5. Plus or minus 5.
Plus or minus 5. Why did we have to put the plus or minus? We square rooted it ourselves. We put the square root sign in the problem, so we have to square root it. We have to have the plus or minus, okay? How would you check it?
You'd... Yeah, you'd plug it back in.
Okay, so...
Oh, yeah.
Now, I want you to be careful of something, okay? Where am I counting? Turn it off.
No. Maybe. It won't come on. Is this one yours? No, because two negatives.
The calculator is wrong. Well, the calculator is trying to do what we asked it to do, right? We asked it to square the 5 and then multiply that by a negative. Is that what we meant to do? What did we mean to ask it? To square the negative 5. How do we tell it to square the negative 5? Parentheses. Would you put negative 5 in parentheses and then square that? Please.
I am ready.
2x squared minus 10 equals 0. What are you going to do first?
Add the 10.
Add the 10, do it. Now what?
Do I have a 2? And then square root it.
Square root, okay. Left-hand side is x. Right-hand side? Do you know the square root of 5?
No.
Me neither. What do you write? Almost. Plus or minus square root of 5. Can you check that?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. I don't want your markers to dry out. It'd be devastating. Oh, sorry.
That's okay.
I gotta find where the glare is not. There we go.
There you go.
Is it 5? Yeah, it's 5. 5.
So times 2?
Hmm?
Times 2.
Oh, yep, sorry. Yep. So, and then negative, well, yes, or would it, like, would you do a negative square root of 5?
Negative square root of 5.
Okay.
Square root of negative 5 is a whole different thing.
It does not work. No, it's false. Did I put it in wrong? I put...
Yeah, you put the negative on the outside.
No.
So I'm just going to get that.
Oh, it put the negative outside of the parentheses.
Like that.
When it... Bam, now it's true, y'all. Maybe. Hold on. Hold on. There we go. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So just keep that in mind, okay? I'm gonna switch. Whoever's next can come back here. Okay, ready? Parentheses? Okay, now you gotta scoot it up so they can see it.
Oh. My parentheses are really bad. Okay.
2x plus 5. Parentheses squared. Minus 1. Equals.
Do we add one first?
Add one to both sides, do it. See, so you guys are figuring out that when you're writing on the projector, you have to write differently than you normally do, right? Because otherwise your hand is in the way the whole time. You notice that? Okay. Now what?
Do we have... Do we do both?
Both sides. Mm-hmm. Almost. And you're getting cut off.
Plus or minus?
Plus or minus. Now what? Subtract 5 from both sides.
Now divide by 2?
No.
Oh.
17's inside the square root. You can't get in there.
Oh.
You can't subtract 5 like that. So cross that out real quick. No, not that. The 12.
Oh, my bad.
Okay, just like, so what is plus or minus the square root of 17 minus 5? I'm going to tell you how mathematicians traditionally write it.
Oh, right here?
Mm-hmm. Where you crossed out.
Uh-huh.
I want you to write negative 5.
Divide by 2? Like this. Go you for doing this every day, Miss Kingston. So plus or minus? No? Minus 5. Plus or minus square root of 17 over 2.
Yeah.
That's the answer?
Yeah, it's a mess, isn't it? But it's still what x equals. How many solutions is that? Isn't it 2? What's one of the solutions?
Minus, negative 5 plus square root of 17 over 2, and then negative 5, negative, minus square root of 17 over 2.
I'm lopsided. All good.
Another page.
I can do another page.
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
X squared. Plus 5x.
Plus 5x. Plus 6. Oh.
Zero.
Equals 0.
Can we square root?
No.
Why can't you square root?
But, I mean, like, because you need to isolate it first.
You'd have to isolate the x squared, and if you isolated the x squared, there'd still be an x on the other side, and I can't do that, can I?
No.
Have you seen a problem like this before?
You can't do it where you just say what applies.
Oh, you want to factor it?
Yes.
Oh, good. Factor it.
I should have counted earlier. Okay. 3 and 2.
3 and 2?
Yeah.
What are you going to write?
X squared. No. Hold up. Let me try again. Okay, you might have to help me out. I think I got lost.
X plus 3. You said 3 and 2, right?
Yeah.
So we're just doing X plus 3, X plus 2.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So X plus 3.
In parentheses.
Oh, darn.
X plus 3 is in parentheses.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay.
Be nice.
And then X plus 2. There we go.
Equals 0.
I died somewhere along there. Okay. Alright. That's better.
Connor, answer me this question.
Yes.
If you have two numbers multiplied together and the answer is 0, what has to be true about one of
them?
Numbers?
One of them has to be 0.
One of them has to be 0. Which one?
We don't know. Yeah.
So we think both of them are.
Both of them are
so
0.
Set
okay.
Each individual factor equal to 0. So you're going to write x equals 0.
Okay. And then x plus 2 equals 0.
Yes.
All right.
Solve.
Okay, so can I just...
Yes.
Yeah, okay, so x equals negative 3, and then x is equal to negative 2.
Correct. Are they both correct?
Yeah, but you could...
How do you know they're both correct?
Because the math is correct. I don't know.
We would check it.
Oh,
right?
You'd check it, yeah.
So take the negative 3
Alright, 6. No, 9. 9.
9.
Alright.
Ooh.
Do I need to do that?
Negative 3 times negative 3 is 9.
It's 9.
So, 9 minus 15?
9 minus 15? No, shoot. It's like negative 4, wouldn't it?
Negative 6.
Because 6 plus
negative 6 plus
9 is that. Negative 6 is 0. Yeah.
So does that work?
Yes.
Okay, so circle
I'm going to put a little check mark.
Check
that's what you
so
do.
That
yeah, that one right there.
Is the second one correct?
Okay, so negative 2 squared is 4. 4 plus 4 plus negative 10 be negative 6 plus 6 is 0 again. So,
that
would also be a check mark, yeah.
So can you solve a quadratic by factoring it?
Yes.
Yes?
Apparently. Yeah. Am I all done?
That was rough.
theorem of algebra says your degree, which is your highest exponent, is how many solutions you should get at the most, right? So if we're solving a quadratic, how many solutions should we get at the most? Two.
Two.
Okay? Guys, I know the word is quadratic, but it doesn't have anything to do with four, just so you know. Okay? So draw me a graph, just the x and y axis real quick. Okay, grab another color. Can you draw me a graph that has two solutions?
Like.
Well, what makes a solution? How do we know it's a solution?
If it crosses the x-axis.
So draw a parabola that crosses the x-axis twice. Underneath it, would you write two solutions?
Mm-hmm. Two solutions?
Two we can have, right? So one, can you draw a graph that only has one solution?
Mm-hmm. With the parabola?
Oh, so the vertex is sitting right on the axis. So that has one solution, right?
Mm-hmm.
One solution. What else is possible?
No solutions.
No solutions. Can you draw me a parabola that has no solutions? And we have to get technical. Just a second.
Okay.
We'll leave that for now.
So we just... So it'd just be that or something?
Yep.
Okay.
Now, we have to get technical. Okay? I need you to add a word to each one of those problems. It's the same word. Or to one of those answers. Real. No real solutions. One real solution. Because if it's a quadratic, there's going to be two solutions. Okay? But we might sometimes only have two real solutions, or we might sometimes have no real solutions. But we still have two solutions. They're just not real. Now, when we're talking about real, we're not talking about real versus pretend. Okay? We don't get pretend solutions in Algebra 2. Right? But we're going to talk about what it means soon. That's some foreshadowing for you. Okay? But for now, you need to realize that it's no real solutions, two real solutions, or one real solution. Got it? So, she's going to take us to solving it by graphing. She pretty much already did, though, right? What are we looking for if we're solving something by graphing?
Where it crosses the x-axis?
Where it crosses the x-axis. Do you know how to find things like that?
Mm-hmm.
So your calculator, okay? So write this question down.
Yep.
I mean, please. y equals 2x squared plus 5x minus 6. So graph that for me. We could graph it by hand if we want to. We don't want to. How many solutions does it have?
Two.
Where are they? So what are you doing right now?
I'm checking to see where it crosses.
So what are you looking for on your table?
Where x equals 0.
Where x equals 0?
Y equals 0. So, wait. See, it doesn't show up there because it's in between lines.
It doesn't show up, so it's in between. So
mm-hmm.
That's a good observation. So is there a way we can find them still?
Mm-hmm.
Get rid of the table. Control-C.
Control-C?
Menu.
Oh. Yeah. Intersection?
Maybe. Intersection usually implies two things that are crossing.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Zeros.
Just zeros.
So just choose okay. number one, zero. Which is weird, because you think zero would be zero.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, it asks you for a left bound and a right bound. So you need to scoot that dotted line over to the left-hand side of one of your zeros. Doesn't matter which one you find first, but you can't find both of them at the same time. That's good. Here. And press the center click button. Now what is it asking for?
Upper bound?
Upper bound. So that needs to go on the right-hand side of one of your zeros.
Does it have to be the same one, or does it matter?
Same one.
Okay.
And then click. You see it show up?
Mm-hmm. Negative 3.39.
They probably rounded it.
Yeah, probably.
Okay, but that's okay for us. Now, can you go find the other one?
Okay, so.
Uh-huh. Well, it's still going to be left and or lower and upper.
Do you want to write that?
Now, if you can't see it, remember, go click on it.
Click on
that. See the hand like that, the little Lego hand? Mm-hmm. Press the control and then the click button. And then you can move it around.
Okay. So it's x equals 0.886.
Mm-hmm. Those are your two solutions that we found by graphing. So what's the main idea of solving by graphing? What are you looking for? What are you looking for?
This, where the it crosses?
Where the graph crosses the
x-axis.
Any questions? Okay, do you have any questions about any of this? Ask as you're working through. If you have questions, ask. Okay?